We want to welcome you to Countdown to Courage. Hope you're having a great day today. It is Thursday, May the 6th, 2021. It's a beautiful day where I am. I hope it's a beautiful day where you are. We're still rejoicing over the blessings of the service of the Lord last night in the service. A tremendous, tremendous time we had together last night. And God sure blessed us, and He blessed our church, enabled us to take on two brand new missionaries last night. And what an exciting time. And if you were there, you know what I'm talking about. It was a great, great time. And we're glad to have you aboard today. I hope you're having a great day. We're going to keep this fairly brief today. And we want to just, if the Lord would allow us, we want to just come into your life just for a few moments and see if maybe we can honor Him and be an encouragement to you today. And so we are glad you are aboard today. We'll do some shout outs here in just a moment, and then we're going to make an announcement, and then we're going to promote a giveaway. And so you might want to hang in there with us just for a few more moments, and we're going to keep the lesson very brief today as well. So if you're able, then stay with us. And by the way, if you're watching today, be sure that you comment so we know you're aboard. Sometimes if you don't comment, we don't see you. And so we would love to recognize you on the air if possible. Let's do that right now. And so, again, we welcome you to the broadcast today. Well, let's see here. It looks like Barry Hooks is on board. And so, Barry, good to see you. And I'm guessing probably Miss Christine. In fact, there Miss Christine is. Barry and Christine watching from Morganton, North Carolina. Good to have the Hooks aboard today. We love you guys. Good to see you. The Gillies are on here with us. And we appreciate Brother Donnie and Miss Tamara in such a big way. And good to see the Gillies on here with us today. Let's see, Almeda Campbell. Almeda, good to see you. I was praying for you and Charles just a little while ago, actually. And good to see you on here, Almeda. God bless you. Stacy Jarvis. Stacy says, I'm watching from Mebane. I think that's the way you pronounce it, Mebane, North Carolina. It looks like Mebane, but I think that's Mebane. And so, Stacy, good to see you today. God bless you, buddy. Let's see here. Lauren Seitz is watching. Lauren, good to see you. Hope you and Abel are having a fantastic day today. Great to see you on here. Abel Seitz, there's Abel. Abel, good to see you. Just wondering if you picked up the lion yet. That's an inside joke. And so I'll let Brother Abel, I'll let him explain that to y'all. And so, Abel, good to see you on here with us today. God bless you. Christine Edwards. Hello, Christine. I hope you're having a great day today. So good to see you on here. Hope you and Gary are blessed today. Patsy Bird is watching. Patsy, good to see you. Hope you're having a good day in harmony today. Rodney Tomlin is aboard. Rodney, good to see you, my friend. I hope you and Allison are having a wonderful, wonderful day today. Nina Hill is aboard. Nina, good to see you. And I'm not sure if you and Brother Mike are back yet, but regardless, it's good to see you and Brother Mike on here. And Brother Mike, we got your text last night. And yes, by all means, we want you involved in our ordination service. Good to see you aboard today. God bless you. Harriet Mason's watching. Harriet, good to see you on this good Thursday. Thanks for tuning in. Brother Seth. Hello, Brother Seth. Maybe Miss Tabitha, but I'd say that's Brother Seth. Good to see Brother Seth Seisloff. And I'll make an announcement about our family conference in just a moment. Brother Seth's going to be with us in just a few days. And I'm going to tell you something. We could not be more excited. And I mean that. It is going to be wonderful. And so, Brother Seth, we welcome you to the broadcast today. Good to see you aboard. Debbie Johnson's watching. Debbie, so good to have you aboard today. I hope you're having a wonderful day. Let's see here. Make sure I got everybody. I think I've got just about everybody. I went back down through yesterday and I missed some folks. And boy, I didn't mean to do that. And sometimes it's like a scroll and you just, it's easy to miss. And so if I missed you, I didn't mean to. It's good to have you aboard today. Some will catch this a little bit later in the day. Some will watch it on the way home from work. Others will catch you on a totally different day. And so anyway, we are glad to have you aboard today. Thank you so much for tuning in. Let me go ahead and take us to the split screen today if I could. And as I said, I want to make mention of our family conference that's just around the corner, May the 16th through the 18th. Our home is where the heart is. Family conference. Man, we are pumped about this. For a few days, Brother Seth Seisloff is going to be with us. Brother Seth is going to be preaching. He's going to be pouring into our homes, into our families. It's going to be a powerful time. Tuesday night, the Nun Sisters will be singing for us. And then we'll have some of our special singers that are going to be singing. I'm going to be honest with you, folks. God's been so good to us at Calvary. We were there last night till almost 11 o'clock. And some of our folks were practicing. And honestly, it was like a little piece of heaven. I mean, it was just wonderful. Our choir's been practicing. I'm going to tell you something, man. I wouldn't miss Sunday for anything in the world. It is going to be out of the banks. And so some of our special singers are going to be singing as well. I'm guessing that the Sisal family is going to sing for us a little bit too. I hope we can convince them to sing for us some. And so it's going to be a wonderful time of music, wonderful time of instruction, great time of fellowship. The service will start at 6 p.m. on that Sunday night. And then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, it'll start at 7. Now, the doors will be open much sooner than that. I encourage you to come a little early, get you a cup of coffee, get you some lemonade. You can browse in our bookstore, come in fellowship, and then the services will begin. And so we're looking forward to a great, great time in the Lord. If you're excited, send up some hearts and some thumbs up. And man, we're looking forward to a great time at our family conference. Now, let me say just a word about this today. We are going to do a book. We're going to promote a book giveaway today. We're going to promote one of our newest books called Are You Ready for Sunday? Now, what we did with this book is we sort of left it in outline form and we sort of left it where Sunday school teachers can use this. Pastors potentially could use this to get a note or a tidbit or an illustration out of it. And so we're going to give this book away. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to like and share the broadcast. Like and share. And I'll have my beautiful little redhead go for us. And she'll get all those names of those folks who are liking and sharing the broadcast. And we will put those names in a container and we'll draw out tomorrow. And we'll give the book away tomorrow on the broadcast. Now, according to your privacy settings, you may want to just comment in the comment section, shared, or I've shared it, so we know exactly who has shared. I just had it open today from a chapter called Some Times When God Purposely Doesn't Show Up. I was just looking through the book right before we went on the air and looking at some of the headings here. Some Times When God Purposely Doesn't Show Up. Number one, I've got this down. When a lesson needs to be taught. Did you ever personally hesitate because your children needed a lesson? Maybe you had challenged them not to do something, but they did it anyway. And then when problems came, rather than bail them out right away, you waited just a bit. God does that sometimes when a lesson needs to be taught. And then number two, why does God purposely wait? Number two, when a leader needs to be pushed. It may be that God purposely allowed you to struggle because he's trying to form you into a leader or force you to lead. Number three, sometimes God purposely waits when a limit has been reached. And I use Saul, King Saul, as an illustration here. Saul has been disobedient. He's reached a limit, and therefore God would no longer help King Saul. Number four, sometimes God purposely waits when a loving Lord has been rejected. Genesis 6:3, and the Lord said, my spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he also is flesh, yet his days shall be 120 years. And on it goes here. And again, we sort of left this in outline form. And so we're going to give this book away. Are you ready for Sunday? Outlines, illustrations, and ideas for preaching, teaching, public speaking. And it's pretty good for reading, I'll be honest with you. And so if you'll like and share the broadcast, we will, Lord willing, we'll give the book away tomorrow. All right. Well, without further ado, let's go ahead and grab our Bibles today, and I'll keep this very brief today. And so we are talking about the signing off. The Apostle Paul is in chapter 4 of 2 Timothy, and Paul's signing off. Paul is getting ready to give his closing remarks. That's what he's doing. And we've talked about a number of things here, but specifically we're talking about this subject today, what it means to fight a good fight. And we're using, of course, 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse number 7. Paul says, I have fought a good fight. I fought a good fight. And this has been the whole premise of our subject this week. How can you call something a good fight? I thought every fight was a bad fight. No, no, no. Now, when Paul uses the phrase a good fight, it means a valuable fight, a virtuous fight. It means a fight with high moral standards. We said this, we said, number one, it's a good fight because it promotes the gospel. Now, that thing that breaks the chains, that thing that gives people a home in heaven, and the gospel does. That's the good news. The glad tidings is what it's talking about there. But number two, we said it's a good fight when you're confident of an ally. Well, hallelujah, I have an ally. His name is Jesus. And I also have an ally in my brothers and sisters in the church. And so if you did not have an opportunity to watch the broadcast yesterday, let me encourage you to go back and catch it on Facebook or YouTube. And so it's a good fight when you're confident of an ally. But number three, and today, it is a good fight when you know it's winnable. Yes, it's a good fight when you know it's a winnable fight. And I'm so glad that, boy, this fight of good and evil is a winnable fight for the child of God. I've got a reference on the bottom portion of your screen, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 7 and 8. Listen to what Paul says. Paul says, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Listen to what he says in verse 8. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all of them also that love his appearing. You know what Paul is saying here? I've already won. I've already won. Now, someone says, how could Paul say that when he's getting ready to lose his head? And Paul says, I'm promised. I'm already promised that I have won this battle. I've stayed faithful, and I've won this battle that I'm in. You know what Paul is saying here? I cannot lose. I cannot lose this fight that I'm in. Hey, Countdown family, aren't you glad? Aren't you glad that you and I are on the winning side today? We're on the winning side. Let me give you some great references here today. How about Romans chapter 8, verse number 35? And the Bible says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Boy, isn't that wonderful? We're not just conquerors. Man, we're more than conquerors, the Bible says. Let me give you another reference here today if I could. How about 1 Corinthians chapter 15? And verse number 55, 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse number 55, the Bible says, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. Listen to this. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, and whenever you see that word therefore, you always go back and see what it's there for. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. I'm so glad that we have, you know what, we have a book that promises us that, my dear friend, we're winners. We cannot lose. If you're in Jesus, you cannot lose. We are more than conquerors in him that loved us. I remember the story I read about the little boy, and he was glued to a book one day, and it was one of these kind of books that was talking about the villain and the bad guy. Back in the day when the good guy wore the white hat and the villain wore the black hat, well, the little boy had read into the book, and at this specific place, the villain looked like he was getting ready to have victory over the good guy. He had him tied up, had him laying on the railroad track, and the train was coming around the side of the mountain, and it was getting ready to run over the good guy. And the villain was laughing in victory, and the little boy was just glued to the book. And all of a sudden, as he was reading, and the good guy's laying on the tracks, and he's tied up and bound, and it looks like the villain is going to have the victory, and the train is getting closer and closer and closer. And all of a sudden, a voice came out of the kitchen from the little boy's mother. And she said, "Johnny, come in here and help me. I need your help." He hollered back in there and he said, "Mama," he said, "I can't come right now." And his mama said, "Johnny, you better get in here and help me." And Johnny was reading the book, and the train was coming around the side of the bend, and it was getting ready to run over the good guy. And Johnny said, "Mama, oh, Mama," he said, "I can't come right now." And his mama said, "Johnny, you better get in here. I'm getting ready to spank you." And so Johnny did what only he knew to do. He turned to the back of the book, and he began to read the back of the book. And a little bit later, he came sort of prancing into the kitchen, and he was saying something like this: "Oh, Mr. Villain, you thought you were going to get the win. You thought you were going to get the victory over the good guy. But," he said, "this, I read the back of the book." And he said, "Mr. Villain, you better hold on, because you're getting ready to get it." Well, you know what, Calvary? You know what, church family? You know what, Countdown family? I've read the last of the book. I've read the last chapter. And I've got some great news for you today. You're more than conquerors. You got the victory in Jesus. Now, if you try to do it without Jesus, you're in trouble. But if you're into the Lord, if you're in the Lord, if you're saved, if you're born again, I've got great news for you and great news for me. We are more than conquerors. Oh, it's a good fight. Well, you know, it is a winnable fight. Well, I'm so glad to have you watching today and listening today. I'm going to put a number on the bottom of your screen there. It's our prayer helpline. If you're watching this broadcast today and you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as personal Savior, would you please call that number right now? It's 704-327-5662. It's in big, bold letters on the bottom of your screen there. 704-327-5662. Let me encourage you to call that prayer helpline number. If no one answers, leave a number, and I promise you, by the grace of God, we'll get back with you. And we would love to connect with you and tell you how you can have a home in heaven, how Jesus will be your Savior. He wants to save you today, by the way. Or if you're watching today and you've got a heavy, heavy burden and you would like someone to pray with you, call this number, and I promise you, by the grace of God, we'll call you back, and we would love to pray with you. Countdown family, don't forget, be kind to everyone, because everyone's having a tough time. Don't forget to pray for us. We'll be in meeting tonight at the Rhonda Baptist Tabernacle in Rhonda, North Carolina, Pastor Blevins, and we're looking forward to a great time in the Lord's house. Please pray for our voice. We covet your prayers for that. And then, Lord willing, we'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow on the broadcast, and we'll give the book away, "Are You Ready for Sunday?" And so I hope that you'll be with us. And then we're looking forward to a great day this coming Lord's Day. Listen, have a good Thursday. It's a beautiful day. God is good. Give Him praise. Be a witness. And we look forward to seeing you tomorrow. God bless and take care.